Yes, I have an appetite. I think, like most actors, for great writing. And strange enough, there are huge holes. I mean, I did sort of leave the theatre and go and work in film for about 20 years. So I've never done Chekhov, never done Noel Coward. Two writers I'd be quite useful in.
Yes.
But Shakespeare, of course, is who we always return to, because for an actor there is just immense depth. You can go on digging and learning and expanding within Shakespeare's writing. Comedy, The Rover, Wild Oats, two restoration plays, very happy doing. I'm not known for my cinema work in comedy, although I know that Rob, my great friend, loves Alan Ayckbourn's Chorus of Disapproval.
A rarely seen film.
A rarely seen film.
Michael Winner?
Michael Winner, yes. Which we could spend a long time talking about Michael, but let's move swiftly on. when I was working with Clifford Williams, who directed this in Wild Oats, and I had a particular line which was an aside to the audience. You know the way in restoration plays, the actors will be talking and then they suddenly make a remark to the audience. And it was a very funny line. And when I was rehearsing it, I was sort of a bit embarrassed because there was nobody out there to talk to. And so I sort of threw it away. And I remember Clifford saying, "You know that's an enormous laugh line, don't you?" And I said, "Yeah, well, I hope they'll laugh, yeah." He said, "Well, you've got to do it. You've got to really do it, aren't you?" I said, "But there's nobody there. We're rehearsing. I can't do it against a brick wall with a load of chairs. But I'll do it." Anyway, on the first night, I got an ovation with the line. And then the second night, I tried it differently. And one of the actors said to me, "Why are you doing it differently? It works." Well, I said, "I know that works, but I want it to be a surprise both to me and to them and to you. I don't want to feel I'm sort of acting in a predetermined way. Because I think when you do that, something dies." And I mean, obviously you have to sort of behave when you're doing a play. You have to be in the same position and say the same lines. But you can do it in many ways that keeps it alive. And Mike Nichols used to say to us, he said, "Acting is like making love. When it stops working, concentrate on each other's eyes and lose yourself in them, and it'll start again." And that's what we did. And so that's what I like to try to do when I'm acting in theatre, is make my other actors sort of not quite sure whether I'll forget the lines, whether I'll be in the right place, whether I'll say the right lines, so that it has a life. Because I think it's quite an art doing a long run. You're repeating. Somebody said to me, "How can you do that?" And I said, "Do you ever ask a surfer that? They swim out into the sea looking for the perfect wave, time and time and time again, day after day after day, and it's always different and they're always looking for perfection." And that's what doing a long run in theatre is. It's always different. And you have to make sure that you keep it frightening and alive.